What's happening, everybody? Sixly here, bringing you another installment of the King of Fighters Reddit podcast. And just where we left off, now we're going to get to the second part of, as Foss would like to say, the patch of the the second part of the big boy, the patch that is King of Fighters 14. And if you guys were going along, and of course, if you have the balance paper, well, actually, before I do that, want to say hello to Fossa. Welcome back.
Hello. Hello.
Of course, he's been the most... Oh, go ahead.
Nah, I'm just saying that this time I'm having the move list just to make things even clearer.
Yeah, exactly. Gotcha. So, yeah. So, we got to the good news, and now we're getting to the bad news. Oh, this is going to be funny.
Yes. And it's gonna be sad.
Yep, feels bad, man. And right off, guess where we're gonna start already with the bad news.
With the baddest of the bad news.
Oh man, poor K-Dash.
And not so much, not poor K-Dash. Like, good on you, K-Dash. Now you are normal.
Pretty much, yeah. He's normalized. That's a good word.
Now you're human.
You're human. All right, so let's go and get started. So, you want to read or I'll read first?
I'll read this one.
All right.
So, the jumping half punch, the hitbox has been shortened. You know, I believe the heavy punch is the downward one, mm-hmm, where he punches down. And the invisibility issue against aerial attacks has been fixed. Something that I didn't even knew happened.
Huh.
I thought that just the move was just that good. Apparently, they had some kind of invincibility, so that me fixed.
Mm-hmm.
Now the meat of the problem. Minute Spike, just in case you people don't know, it's the first move of the quarterback kick. They are divided in two moves, the Minute Spike when he jumps and the Narrow Spike when he lands. So just so you're clear, so Minute Spike, damage and guard crush value has been reduced. So if you didn't follow with the Narrow Spike, you are still positive. So that's something important. They probably did that so the K-Dash could still have some good pressure. The Narrow Spike, the overall recovery time has been increased just because it was kind of stupid. Mm. And the time allowed to follow up with another tech has been reduced. And that last line is the big K-Dash nerf. That means that he cannot follow with much right now. He can still follow with some things. I saw we have the Canada Cup this weekend, and we saw some players trying different things.
Mm-hmm.
Even Xiao Hai that played in a lot. Sometimes would just hard punch or try the CD, but that only worked if it started a Minute Spike on air, so it's not that easy. And if the opponent is on the corner, you can do the light crow bite. That's pretty much all he can do now. Before he could do, well, everything. So now, light crow bite or normals.
Mm-hmm.
That's the follow-up now. The Narrow Spike EX version is still very positive. So if you are on EX, don't worry, you are still positive, but the damage and the guard crush have been reduced. Since I didn't see that much guard crush with K-Dash, or maybe I just look at the wrong games, I believe it's just a normalizing thing, but I didn't think the character was that strong in Guard Crush, but maybe. So those are the main changes to the spikes, and that was the big nerf. And we are talking about real nerf here.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the character lost most of his follow-ups, and at least from what we could see, he's still very strong. So it's not like they nerf him into oblivion. They nerf him into fairness.
Yep.
For now. The next thing, the Eintrigger. Eintrigger, I believe is the
correct name. Yeah, Eintrigger, I think it's pronounced.
Yeah. No more meter is added. So, let's just be clear. No more Street Fighter Third Strike techniques.
Third Strike meter meta.
Yeah. You cannot Eintrigger for 3 minutes, then 30 seconds, and then fight. Now you have to do one of the follow-ups to create meter. Mm-hmm. And it's funny, I went back to some old games and I discovered that the Eintrigger generating meter is one of the most balancing changes they happen from game to game. It created meter in 99 and 2000. It didn't create it in 01 and 02. It did create it in 03. It did not create in 11. It did create in 13. It did not create in 02 Ultimate Match. And now in 14, it happens in both. So, yeah, it's something that not even SNK knew exactly what to do. But from what I could gather, not generating meter is probably the best option, at least from the perspective of people watching. I don't know how the players feel about it. And even you, Ciclet, you don't play with K-Dash, right?
It's funny because I was expecting that maybe what will happen is that if he builds meter, it's like barely noticeable. Because in 13, you actually don't build meter.
No. Yeah. You build some meter, but it's so little.
Or maybe it was, like I said, maybe it was so little that it's almost unnoticeable. Because I noticed that there are some moves that you're like building meter, but boy, you're like wasting time trying to build meter on such a sliver of meter. And I find it funny that now he doesn't get no meter at all. I'm like, oh, wow, never mind.
Maybe it's hard to balance something like that. Especially the Eintrigger in 14, it's first frame active. So as a move, it's better than it was in 13. So maybe that's what they were thinking.
That's fine. No, that's still fair regardless. Yeah. I was surprised that, oh, wow, okay, never mind. No meter altogether. I was expecting like just sliver. It's like, see.
And then we have some changes to the follow-up. The weirdest one, in my opinion, is that the light punch follow-up, mm-hmm. the one where he moves down, you know, like he punches down the flame.
Yeah,
that didn't have any change. Because of that, it's one of the few Eintrigger moves that can be used on the opponent if he's on the corner. The main problem is the crow bite does more damage, so it's not really a... Other than that, they all got somehow nerfed. Second shoot, the kick, where he kicks the fireball, mm-hmm. is no longer nullified after being hit by opponent. So, it got a buff.
Well, at the same time, it doesn't. We won't get that weird thing where you still hit him and the fireball will disappear. Will still remember that weird thing?
Yeah.
It was weird.
But now, and it used to work like that on the other games. If you're hitting and the second shoot is on the way, it still is on the way.
Mm-hmm.
But on a character that's so strong, it's different to see that they would still fix some things just because of logic reasons, you know.
Mm-hmm.
The second shell, probably the best new follow-up, that's the high kick.
Yep.
The hitbox has been shortened, so that's probably just not enough to be noticeable, since I play a little with K-Dash and I didn't see that much different with the second shell.
Basically,
and the amount...
Let me put it this way. Basically, you cannot definitely think outside of his kick because there was a slight outer hitbox to it. And that's why you see some combos. Like now with that nerf they had with the an arrow spike, you can't do like a lot of combos in that category.
What I see is since I didn't play K-Dash on the same level, I never noticed exactly the point where the second shell used to hit, you know? It just used to hit. That's all I saw.
Yeah, no,
so
but
now it's a little sharp.
Yeah, no, yeah, it was noticeable because it's probably not by much, but I didn't notice that. Oh, okay, now I can see how much they reduced the hitbox. It was really not noticeable, but noticeable on combos. Like, oh, okay, now I see why they had to change the combo.
Got it. And someone told me that because of that, one of the trials is now hard as fuck to do.
Interesting.
Yeah. Because they changed the move and you're supposed to do a second shell like mid-screen. Mm-hmm. And now you have to, when you activate the max, you have to move like almost, you have to be on the guy to work.
Yeah.
So now you know. It's the fifth one or the fourth one. I don't know. Remember. And both in second shell and second knuckle, now they generate more meter. So you don't generate meter with I trigger, but the hard moves and they have a slower startup generates meter. I believe it's probably the same amount, but now it's generated only by the follow-up, not by the I trigger. Mm-hmm. And now the some of other kind of glitches that they fix, the X I trigger is now also the first frame activation. Somehow the I trigger EX before the patch, it was the same speed it was in 13, so 2-3 frames, still fast, but not as fast. Mm-hmm. And it only happened in the X. Now they fixed that for the X. And the hitbox remains for a while after the follow-up has been removed. So I don't know exactly what that means, but I believe the I trigger now lasts a lot longer than it used to. Maybe they didn't change the animation, but if the fire is on the screen and you jump on it, it will hit.
Okay.
Before it looked like you could hit the opponent even if the eye trigger appeared active, but in fact it was not. So they fixed that.
Okay.
Second shoot, so the EX version of the fireball, is no longer nullified by hitting the opponent. So same thing of the normal, and the hitbox has been shortened. I don't know exactly what that means since we are talking about a projectile. What I'm going to say that it's something lost in translation. I just believe it's a smaller hitbox overall, not just shortened. Shortened doesn't mean much on a fireball. I believe you can hop over now. That's pretty much it.
Yeah.
And that's K-Dash. A lot of changes from the character that was by far the most used on tournaments, mm-hmm. at least in the last month. And even players, people who plays with K-Dash and knows that, like, oh, man, he's been nerfed, like, yeah, that's fair. We cannot complain, you know? We won't be pissed about it. Mm-hmm. So K-Dash got nerfed bad. The rest of his team otherwise seems to be got a lot better. So Kula, that by the way won a tournament in Canada Cup. So Shohai went full waifu team.
That's like his secret. That's like his secret thing where he did this last time, but I forgot where he just brought out a Kula out of nowhere. It's like a secret waifu pick whenever.
For the finals, finals, exactly. Sure, whatever. I'm going with my waifu team.
Yeah, I'm still in winners on the grand finals, so I can just, you know, test the waters, right?
If I could have been classified more than one times, I would have been classified every single tournament. So yeah, he's very, he's probably crying himself to sleep. So we have the Kula who got some nice buffs for all the Kula lovers, and I know there are a lot on the subreddit. Max mode activation. And that's weird. It's the only time on the 19 pages of patch that we see that kind of change. Max mode activation. Her missing throwable box has been added. I have no idea what it means.
Actually, here's what I'm willing to bet. There is a way where you can punish improper max activates so that you can throw. You can like grab them. Like if they do a jab that's not like block stung enough and they try to like hit you with a heavy punch, you can probably throw them. I'm guessing what that means is that you couldn't throw her at all during max activation. Which is a weird glitch. I guess like a weird programming that happens.
And also something that we don't see that much because we don't usually punish max mistakes with a throw, you know? Mm-hmm. You have like full range for a combo start, so I don't know. Well, that's having fixed it. It's probably just a bug. The far light kick hitbox has been increased. And that's kind of weird. I saw some videos. I believe Gato Ray put some videos about it. She hits like she it's like she has the skates on the on
her feet. I know, right?
But she doesn't have any more. In the 14, she doesn't have the skates on her when she kicks. But now it has the same range. So
it has the same range.
It's just a little outside of her body. Mm-hmm. So that's weird. Ray spin, heavy version. Damage value has been increased. So, sure. I believe it's like the bread and butter of her combos, and the damage is a little higher now. Just straight up above. Not a big deal. The Ray Spin Stand EX version can no longer be canceled from a normal or high jump. So I don't know exactly what that means. Can it still be canceled from a hop? Maybe. So that's something that I will let cooler players tell me what it is.
Wait, can she? Does that mean she can do that in the air now?
I believe so.
That's like the only. I like how it says Ray Spin Stand as if. Wait a second, there's an air version?
Yeah, that's. I thought weird too, but since we have no more. Oh, I know what it is. Ray Spin Stand is the light kick version, and she has a heavy kick version where she slides on the floor. It's the follow-up, not the move.
Oh, I was going to say, cancel from a normal... That's even weird. Like, okay, I never heard of you.
It makes even less sense because you have to Ray Spin first, so I don't know. Maybe it was some kind of glitch they fixed.
Yeah, that's like, wait, why does this sound like something off of like Guilty Gear where you can just press a normal button and jump cancel? And that's like, it's like, no, that can't be right. What's that?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Huh. Counter shell. So her counter projectile hitbox has been increased. It's still shorter than Athena, but the hitbox is a little larger. Don't know exactly how it will work, since they didn't say how it increased, like increase up or down, or maybe now it works on Kukri, since before it would just go below her counter shell. About to see. And the Diamond Edge, the damage value has been reduced. Diamond Edge is the super... Where she... Diamond Edge is the slide or the burn knuckle, like the ice knuckle.
Pretty much ice knuckle. I think that's what Diamond Edge is. Because I remember I see that name a lot. So it's basically Ice Geyser when you think about it.
Ice Geyser, yes. Yeah. So that's the damage has been reduced. I don't know by how much. Probably not that much since nobody complained about it. So Kula got some buffs, a lot of bugs. She looks like she had, and the only real nerf was the damage of the
super
Diamond Edge.
Yeah.
Maxima, our boy Max, Mega Man. So Guard Cancel Blowback is now invisible to opponent grabs.
Huh.
If someone is able to abuse it, I can see that being awesome.
Interesting.
Yeah, something that no other character has, you know?
Sure. Yeah, and even that was even a thing in general where you can just grab someone's guard cancel blowback.
And neither did I.
Yeah.
Short and medium jump, heavy punch. The active frames have been shortened.
Oh, no.
Also, that. Yeah, that's the body slam, right?
No, that's because for you to do the body slam, you have to do a high jump. If you short hop, right. You're just doing like the punch. It looks like the light punch, but with his other arm.
Well, he still has the body slam.
No, yeah, he still has the body slam. But to do the body slam, you have to do a high jump or a normal jump.
True.
Yeah, it cannot be. Got when it. You hop, you would do a different normal in the air.
It was probably something they saw on the game data, you know, game data. Mm-hmm. Since we didn't saw that many Maximas, maybe we lost it, but probably it was a very stupid hitbox on that scene.
It must have been really active then, because it's like,
yeah.
Typically, if I want to land a short hop, a heavy punch into an air version of the punch, vapor punch, then I had to really time the button. But wow, and I now guess it must have been leading then.
And now we have those things that prove me that I don't play Maxima enough. The N9 Maxima missile is the command normal.
Yes, because it says prototype, which is I remember that quotation. It's the down forward heavy punch.
Yes, the right. It's pretty much a high punch, right? It's mm-hmm. it's a hook.
Yep.
The hitbox has been shortened. Also, didn't notice that it was that big before. But
yeah, I was gonna say I should investigate it. I played him too. I guess I didn't pay enough attention.
Yeah, you like Maxima, yes. Mm-hmm. But I know why some of those changes happen, and that's because of the next two moves. So the Vapor Cannon, everybody's favorite, not projectile. Mm-hmm. Now bounces back on
yep,
the
ball. Yep.
So, and that's why they changed the command normal. Just so you have to be a little more careful with timing to do another move, right?
Actually, sorry to interrupt you. Now that I think about it, actually, no. That's a good thing. Because if you hit the down forward heavy punch at the tip, your anti-air grab will completely miss because it was way too high. So that's actually a good thing.
So now we have the now we know.
Yeah.
So that's it. So Vapor Cannon with the wall hit, nice. We mm-hmm. needed that. Maxima needed that. And the air version of the EX, it's now on overhead.
Which was never a thing, actually.
Yes, it was never a thing. Yeah. So now you Vapor Cannon overhead.
Fuck
and it kind of makes sense being on overhead. Unlike some other moves that are overheads. So, I don't know. You play Maxima. What do you think?
No, that's great because he really doesn't have some sort of overhead pressure. It's like I had to like short hop light punch. And, well, either way, that still makes it obvious where I had to, like, hop to an attack. But that's awesome sure. that, because what can happen here is that if I wanted to get cheeky, I would do the air Vapor Pan EX and do it one more time so I can create a fake up and down pressure. Force him to block low so that I can do it one more time and I can catch him. I can do, like, an instant overhead.
Sure.
Kind of thing.
And you can always grab. That's the main thing with grapplers, or at least partially grappler characters, that you have another option for mix-up. So maybe mm-hmm. that's what they are trying to do.
Yep.
Also, still talking about Maxima, since he lost the... What's the move? Ah, man. You know what I'm talking about.
Oh, the Mongolian. One where
the Mongolian, yes.
The Mongolian chop.
Yeah, the Mongolian chop. Why did they remove that move? Really? Why?
You got me there.
Give me a good.
That was actually one of his best command normals.
Yes.
But look,
and it was an overhead.
But look, at least, let me remind you, they gave him back his standing low, which that was important. He didn't have that in 13.
Yeah, but that was 13 problem. In 13, we could always blame the production cost, right?
Yeah, but it's fine. Like I said, fine. We don't get the Mongolian chop, but give me a standing low, then good. There we go. Now sure. I got pressure. Sure. You know, I got pressure now.
Sure. Now we are going to the not that many buffs or nerfs character. So Geese, far have kick, hitbox has been increased. I don't know if that was a problem before. The short medium jump with heavy punch, the hitbox size of the third and fourth hits has been shortened, and the active frames for the third and fourth hits have been reduced. I am such a Geese noob that I didn't even knew that his heavy punch jumps were multiple hits.
It was, yep.
So now it looks like it's a little unsafer. And lastly, the Fodoken hitbox has been increasing. So that's pretty much it with Geese. Mm-hmm. As far as I knew, it's a character that all he needed was to K-dash to be worse so he could be used.
Yeah.
That's it. Because otherwise, he's still a very strong character.
Mm-hmm.
Just so we are clear, Fodoken is the Hippoken, right?
Repeat that again.
Fodoken is the... Oh, no. Fodoken is the combo starter. Ah, right. Got it.
Yeah, I was going to say.
So, yeah. It's not the Rippuken, of course.
No. Rippuken is Rippuken. Fodoken. I forgot which one. I thought... I was trying to think. Was that either the counter hit or the little rush combo that he does?
Yeah. Billy, the bow... No, that will be hard. Botakatobi Geri. I know how Geri is pronounced because of judo. Changes into high attack. I don't know what that move is, so I'll let
probably judgment used to be for low. Another people. Yeah. That's like the only reason they would say, oh, change to high attack. Oh, maybe it was a low or mid, I guess.
Yeah, but I don't know. It's because his common normal is a jump, so probably that's not it. I don't know what movies that is.
I thought you had the move list. If
I can. I have to open one by one, and SNK site, SNK web pages on Japan, not that fast.
I thought there was an English version that we can see what's what.
Yes, and it's still .co.jp/US, you know. We know where the servers are. So, Botakatobi Geri is the command normal with the front light kick.
Oh, yeah. That should have been a high the whole time. Forward light kick, right?
Yeah, forward light kick, yeah.
Wow, so why wasn't it high attack? I guess they accidentally made it mid. That's weird. It's supposed to be high.
That's probably just a bug.
Yeah, it must have been a bug because when it's high attack, obviously it has to miss crouchers in a way. Well, depending on the character. But that's interesting. It must have been a bug then because it's like, wait, it should have just been high the whole time. Okay.
Then the other moves is the where he get out of screen and go back, the Kyoshu Hishokun. The time allowed to add another attack has been increased.
Oh, really?
Sure.
Basically, yes. You know that it juggles, right? Just like in 13, where if you do the DP. Okay, wow, then I guess they messed that up, because typically you would get juggles.
Yes.
But I guess now you do.
And look, in the EX version, the issue that was changing the landing behavior when the first hit didn't confirm has been fixed. So a bug.
Another bug, okay.
Nothing else.
Gotcha. Yeah, bug fix.
Hein got buffs all around. Like, a lot of buffs.
Oh, yeah. Good ones, too. Yeah.
Yes. Knight. Knight is the
command
grab. Hydran jump.
Oh, the yeah, thank you. The Hydran jump. Yep, that's right.
Hydran jump. Can now hit crouching opponents. Both the normal and then and the EX version. That's good. Hydran didn't.
There you go.
So now we have that.
We don't have the T-Zog effect.
No.
Like in Garou.
Yes. Oh, no. Don't. the hardest character to play and lose.
I know.
T-Zog and Garou. Queen is the super rare with the Hush attacks, you know, the multiple hits one.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Climax Cancel can now be activated on the 8th and 13th hit. That means that it can be activated on the last hit. So, more damage.
Yep.
So, the Climax can be cancelled a lot earlier. So, good for Hein.
Yep.
Solid buffs. But you know who got nerfed?
I'll read this one. But honestly, it's funny because it's not even... I had to like test that out because I wasn't aware of it. But, so, one of my bays, King. All right, so... Okay, I'll read the first two because they're like the same thing. Far Heavy Kick and Jump Heavy Kick. Both hitbox sizes has been shortened. I guess they were much further than I realized because I've always remembered her hitbox. It's always been similar in every game possible. It's always been the same roundhouse and the jump kick. I guess they were much stronger than I expected in 14. I wasn't aware of it. So, yeah. Sliding, the hurtbox size has been increased. That's fair. Because, boy, if you can learn how to get the tip of sliding, you can do some scummy things. And I can understand that if you can't hit me out of it, even if you, like, normal jump it, then it makes sense that I had to get punished. So if you read me trying to slide from far, then you should be able to hit me. So it's
but
fair.
That is a drastic change from 13, where her amazing common normal in the game.
Repeat the last part. OBS cut you off.
Oh, sure. The sliding on 13 was even better than it was in 14, and they still nerfed it, probably because they thought it she was too strong or too easy, maybe.
Well, it's just her hurtbox, which I guess they must have noticed that, wow, I guess somehow, like, you know, if you do a proper neutral jump and you try to punish me and somehow you still miss, it's like, wait, that's not cool, you know. You should be able to hit my foot, basically. So it makes sense. It's just it just means that now you can punish me. I can't just, you know, be crazy about it.
Yes.
So I can, you know, me being, you know, always play keen, it's fair because I abuse the shit out of that move. So it's only fair. And now Venom Strike and even the EX version, hitbox size has been shortened, which, as we already mentioned all around, you know, projectiles pretty much have been like nerfed anyways, so
yes,
it's nothing new.
So yeah, and the Venom Strike was it was the what we expected, nothing new.
It's
but
funny.
What I didn't expect.
Go
for it.
No, actually, go. I forgot what you're gonna say. What you're gonna say?
just saying that with the nerf of the Venom Strike, that's kind of weird because in the projectile height of the game, the Venom Strike was always one of the lowest one, you know, that is not a ground projectile. So even King of Dinosaurs could just hop over Venom Strike.
Yeah, so, I know. That was always weird. I guess it was much stronger, I guess, previously, or I guess there was something about it, or maybe it was wide. I'm willing to bet that the hitbox was wide, and maybe that's what that's what they shortened, possibly.
That's possible.
Because I think technically, even if you jump over it, if you miss your jump, you would get hit by the tail end. I think I noticed sometimes that was like, oh, that's weird. That's weird actually. I hit because like you clearly jumped over it and you still got hit. And I'm like, well, it must have been the tail.
No, we know.
Yeah. And then Surprise Rolls Max can now be canceled into her climax at the 18th hit, which is, I guess it must have been a bug because I thought you could always, you know.
No, you know what? From what I saw, you can cancel it on the last hit. 18 hit is the last hit.
Oh, really?
So,
oh.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
So that made some people say that King Anchor is now legit. You can be happy.
Okay.
You can play King.
All right, she does one more kick. I'm sorry, I keep forgetting. She does that. Yeah. She actually now she does that one last kick, and I'm so used to 13.
Yes, she does the standard.
You're right. Oh, yeah. Okay. I forgot about that. See, that's why I haven't got a chance to play all of it. But yeah, I forgot now that she has a last kick. That's right. I forgot about that. Okay. Good to know.
So now you can put her right in the back, spam the 5 bars, and do 600 damage with 2 moves.
I've always put her back anyway, so.
Yeah, sure.
I'm that guy.
But now it's legal. Yeah. Now you don't have to hide from your friends. Yeah.
Okay, well, let me continue the team since this is pretty much my second main. Maeshia Nui. Sure. Sankaku Tobi. I'm guessing Tobi. Hopefully I pronounced that right. The flying distance and time has been adjusted.
I'm trying to get what move it is. What's the move?
That's the flying attack, I'm guessing. It's the hold down up punch.
Sankaku Tobi.
Yeah, because it says flying distance.
It's the wall jump.
Oh. Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, that has a name?
Yes.
What the hell? Okay. I forgot that. I didn't realize that had a name. I wish it would just say wall jump. All right, whatever.
We are stupid gaijin, Sankaku Tobi actually supposed to mean wall jump, you know, like something that's stupid.
My bad. I mean...
No, our bad.
Like, I forgot it has a name. I guess you're right. It is listed on the command list, which is weird. Because, like, I guess I didn't know there was a... That's how you translate. Okay. Far light kick. The hitbox has been shortened. The overall recovery time has been increased. Really?
That's one of the moves that probably is the far hard kick. Far heavy kick. And it was a translation error.
Oh, okay, yeah.
The far heavy kick was actually kind of stupid.
Yeah, no, I'll admit that. I love that move. I was like, wow, this button. This is like, I don't remember, like, this was like 2002 UM. I don't remember being this strong.
This button, it does everything.
And I remember for a hard read jump, but the fact of, in 14, I'm like, well, hey, wow, okay, I'll hit it again because I recover so fast for a heavy kick. That is, oh geez, that was funny. All right, jump heavy punch. The active frames have been reduced. Huh?
It's the fan, right?
Yeah, the fan. Yep.
The fan. Yeah.
Huh?
Didn't know that much.
Yeah. No. I guess it was more. I guess it was really active. Then again. Sure. You can do really nifty you know what? That's what it is. You can really do ambiguous cross-ups with that heavy punch. And I guess it makes sense that it shouldn't be that active because you have to do it at such a weird height that it's not gonna always combo. So it actually makes sense. You have to like be precise about it. If you want to combo into it, you better do it right. You can't just get away with doing it at like a it shouldn't be active for that long. So it's fair. So I can understand that.
Sure.
And then the Kagori no Mai. I'm guessing that's the fire super? The pillar fire one?
No, that's the charge move.
Oh, the charge move. Okay. Yeah, I was going to say. I forgot. Yeah. No, wait. You sure? She says it too. Kagori no Mai.
I'm reading. Oh, no. I'm not reading. Forget. Yeah, stop. Sorry. It's the super.
Yeah, because I was going to say.
No, don't blame me. The charge movie is Musabi no Mai.
Oh, you're right. It sounds familiar. But yeah, but I remember when I hear the screen, Kage no Mai, it's like, oh, wait, no, that's actually, it's just like in the old games. I can hear it. And it's definitely the fire super. But you're right. It sounds similar. No, I got you. No, you're good. The issue, increasing the number of hits when super canceling into Kage no Mai, a max version, hasn't been fixed. Actually, what you know about this? This one's interesting. I'm not even...
Nothing. Not at all. I probably... So... I didn't even knew that was a thing.
should increase in.
Maybe I don't know if it did less hits or more hits, so don't know.
Unless it has to do with if you accidentally bounce him way too high and you try to do like the max version, oh, then awesome. it just bounces. I remember I see weird moments where it's like it's a max version. You would think that no matter what height they are, it would do like the most amount of hits. But I remember it would accidentally bounce off after two hits, and they jump off, and it's like, whoa, what the hell? Damn, that sucks.
Yeah. So probably it's probably just a fix on the
fix. If that's what I'm thinking, because I haven't seen it done in tournament, so that I can actually notice the difference.
Same.
Yeah. So otherwise, yeah, I would easily tell you because I do play her, I do main her, I just haven't done enough like lab work to notice these things. And last from the women's team, now we got Alice, and I'm sure everyone was hoping a lot of things for her, but you're only going to see a few things here. So, crouching light kick can now be canceled with special moves, which is, that's
actually pretty good.
Yeah, that's actually pretty good. This is actually typical. Like, not everyone can cancel off of a crouching light kick. Yes. Typically, you have to do crouching light kick, crouching heavy punch, and then cancel. But I guess they're going to give it to her. I was like, okay, that's true. Cool. Garnet spin. The behavior when hitting the opponent in the air has been adjusted.
Garnet spin, it's the command normal.
The command, yeah. I did see weird stuff on Twitter about that. So, yep. And then Wolf combination. Oh, go ahead.
I don't know. Garnet spin, it's an overhead, right?
Supposedly, yes.
Yes. So, I believe now if you hit the opponent on the air, you cause a knockdown.
Okay. Oh, you're right. It doesn't knock like, him down. Yeah.
Just like Leona.
Yeah, gotcha. Okay. That definitely makes sense. And Wolf combination, the command input issue has been fixed. Okay, interesting. Yeah, must have been a bug then.
Yeah, that's something that some people notice. The Wolf combination is the 1-2-3, the Rekkas.
Yeah, the Rekkas.
So it was not that easy to do the three consecutive quarterbacks. Because they used to still keep some of the previous input. So it was kind of hard. A lot of people seem to have problem with that, especially casual players, of course. No?
Mm-hmm.
That spam a little more, press the light punch more than once. So they fixed that, and now it works just like the like Yoris. So it's more than... The main difference and the reason why it's different, it's because her moves are a lot faster. So 1-2-3 is a lot faster than the Yoris Rekkas. Mm. But now you can input on mostly the same speed than you should use before. So that's it.
Gotcha.
Look who's next.
Oh. The hawk. It's now fried.
Fried the chicken. Hawk man. The hawk man.
Oh, yeah. All right.
Now I'll you have to away. Play with Nakoru. And now you have to play with Nakoru.
Yep.
So now you can choose Nak as a player. As not Mamaha. So let's go. I don't know. Did you play Persona?
I know, right? Yeah, you're definitely playing. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. You know, when you used to play with Ken, you were actually playing with Kotomaru.
It's exactly the same thing. Yep.
So now you play with Nekoruru proper.
Mm-hmm.
So let's start with the easy one. Sankaku Tobi. Just in case you people didn't know, Nakoruru has a wall jump.
Yep, she does.
And you can see that it's called wall jump because it's exactly the same name as my move.
Mm-hmm.
So her wall jump now has been fixed and we don't know for... Now let's go to the meat of it. Crouching half punch. Hitbox has been shortened. Active frames have been reduced. That was probably the biggest biggest move outside of Mamahaha's pen. Mm-hmm. It was a very, very safe move, very strong. It had a vertical range that it was pretty much it was pretty much the heel's DP, and also have a very large horizontal range that didn't make any sense, mm-hmm. because her hand didn't got nowhere near the guy to hit. So from what I could gather, they didn't nerf that much the height. They nerf a lot the width. So that's something to be. And of course, the active frames have been reduced in all cases. So big nerf, big nerf.
Yep.
Jumping half kick, the hitbox has been shortened. Don't know exactly what it means.
Pretty much like similar now, issue to Keen. So
probably,
her,
yes.
Her jump heavy kick must have been that strong as well.
The bird. Now it works with projectiles, okay? So Mamahaha, he used to go over any kind of projectile, but now it only goes over projectiles of the same level.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are using against like, I don't know, the Koken from Robert, mm-hmm. if you use the normal Mamahaha, it will cancel the Koken. But if he does the max Koken, the normal Mamahaha will not cancel. The same goes all the way to the specials, where Mamahaha don't cancel anyone anymore. There's not a single super or max or climax that Mamahaha is able to cancel.
Mm-hmm.
But you can max cancel another max moves. That's just it. Yeah. Clinging to Mamahaha, that by the way is not a move. Invincibility has been reduced. From what I could gather, it has been reduced. It's the proper name. She still has some from the moment where she leaves the ground. You cannot low hit her. You know, like she works more or less like a DP.
Yep.
So yeah, the hurt box size when on Mamahaha increase. Also, it means that most moves that are able to hit up can hit her. So yours DP that's very vertical can hit her even so. Except when she flies, okay? So if she goes up high, there's nothing you can do. The amount of time Nakaruru can be hanging on Mamahaha has been shortened. Just so you're clear, I never knew that she had a time limit.
Almost didn't seem like it.
I never saw someone go all the way to until she drops off, you know?
I have, actually. Corsi, the freaking Reynolds, and I forgot who he's playing. They both were trolling each other, clinging to Mamahaha, waiting for one of them to do something. And eventually, one of them did fall. There is a maximum. There is a time limit.
Now it's shorter. I don't know how much shorter.
It better be noticeable.
Yes, it better be.
Oh, jeez. Also, for those that they're like, what? She still has to miss. It's much noticeable. It's much more noticeable to punish now. So don't you worry. You can now punish it easier.
Yeah.
So even though she still has the invisibility, you can still hit her much easier, basically.
Yeah, the next two moves are the follow-ups to the Mamahaha Kling.
Mm-hmm.
So Kamui Mutsube is the downward slash.
Yeah, downward slash.
When she's on the bird, yes. Irusuka Yatoru is the... No, oh, okay, so good news and bad news. The follow-up where she slashes the ground, the landing time has been increased up to recovery, so it's okay. But the overhead still works pretty much the same. No change there.
Yeah.
And the Irusuka Yatori Himusi, it's the Mamahaha special, Mamahaha super.
Yep.
Just like the regular Mamahaha, the EX will, the normal will go over normal supers. The max version will go over max
regular version. Super. Oh yeah, yeah, max, yeah.
Yeah. And no version can go over Sylvie's Climax.
Mm-hmm.
I believe, or
if anything, Joe's all it does is cancel one hit, and that's it.
Not even that. Just nothing happens. It goes through.
I don't know. It felt like it took away a hit because I could have sworn really? Sylvie does 5 hits on her climax.
It traditionally. Really does 5?
Yeah, like this. Where was, I might be wrong, but just in case, because I thought I saw, because I was looking at comparisons, and I could have swore it did 5 before, and whenever Mamaha does her, like, whatever, super, or whatever, all you're doing is, like, canceling one of the hits, but the rest will still hit you. But like I said, don't take my word for it just in case. It's what I saw in the video.
Did you miss something on this list?
Why? Are you going to surprise me with something?
The Anomatsube, it's still the most positive move in the game. Her slide.
Yep, that's right, that's right, that's right.
They didn't change at all the slide. So they want her to be strong, and that's all you need to know. SNK put neck on the game to be strong. Okay?
Strong anyways, just that now you definitely gotta play her. The new meta is now her. And rely less on the bird.
Yes. So now you play Neck. Also, a character that they suppose was Love. Mm-hmm. So Love got some pretty heavy nerfs.
Yeah, pretty heavy.
The crouching heavy punch, also known as
the wind button.
Shouldn't hit.
The wind button.
So everything has been nerfed. Hitbox shortened. Hurtbox increased. Recovery increase. Okay. that was hard. That was heavy.
Ugh.
The jump CD hitbox has been shortened. Active time has been increased. It's more or less the proper move, because come on, she slaps the guy.
Yeah,
all she does. The PC slash. The damage value has been reduced, but that was not actually the problem. The real problem is the second hit is no longer an overhead.
Mm-hmm.
And it's now a high attack. It's the opposite of what we are expecting.
Yep.
So that is also not that spammable. And the Elysian Wave, both versions, damage has been reduced. So, okay, those are OTG supers. They have been reduced. So, yeah, what we're expecting Neck to receive, Love ended up receiving. Love only got nerfs. Everything was nerfed.
Love only got hate.
Only got hate, yeah. Hate heart.
Oh, yep. Man.
So, I'm sad because I like Love. I like the design. She's hot. But, yep. I have to take a minute to talk about Loveheart. Is a character from the design standpoint on KOF. There's no one else, not even similar to her, you know?
Oh, yeah,
she's a tall, thin girl. She doesn't have huge boots. Boots is boobs and boots and butts. She doesn't have that. She's a slim, tall girl with a lot of flair to her, and I would like SNK to use that model for more characters. Just saying, everybody looks like Vice. Muy muy. Oh yeah, Vice is the standard body.
SNK yeah, pretty body. Much. Yeah, Vice is the standard. Yeah,
yeah. Muy muy. Backward emergency evasion. The aerial hitbox issue has been fixed. I don't know what that is. I actually don't know what that is. Yeah, it's probably the back row.
Yeah, but
aerial hitbox.
Aerial hitbox issue. Oh, that was that must have been an interesting book.
Yep.
Okay. Sure.
Far heavy kick. Hitbox has been increased. Overall recovery time has been increased. That's still a good move, by the way. The just hits a little further. Crouching heavy punch. The missing collision box has been added. A lot of people were complaining about it.
Wow.
Okay. Yes, that was an actual problem. You have to be on the, like, you have to be glued to the guy, to the move, to do anything. Now it actually hits where her hands is. Noten Kudaki. It's the Noten Kudaki. It's the, yeah, it's her command normal.
Oh, that's right. It is, because now it's an overhead. That's yes. Right. It told me about that. Oh my god, they give her an overhead now. Yep.
So it's a little slower for a startup, but now it's an overhead.
Yeah, well, I mean, it makes sense. When you want an overhead, it can't be fast.
Sure. Hyosenshu. Hyosenshu is the it's the Kyo kick, you know, the two kicks in the air.
Okay, yeah, gotcha. Yep.
With the launcher, yeah. Damage has been increased, hitbox has been increased. It's probably better than Kyo now.
Mm-hmm.
And her special, her super, the Enten Goryuha, that is the kick one. I don't know what the kick one is. The one that is not the okay. It's the other one that I never saw. I don't know what she does. Well, aerial hitbox during the land recovery frames has been removed. So I believe you could punish her with when she was landing, and now you can't. That's it.
Interesting.
Now some from here onward, we have some interesting changes, but nothing as massive until the very last character. So I will try to go then as fast as possible and just stop if we saw something that is interesting to talk about. So, Ramon, the Sankaku Tobi, the flying distance and time has been just adjusted. So, in our Japanese lesson today, we learned that Sankaku Tobi means wall jump. Yeah, that's... So, wall jump. Crouching light kick can now be canceled into standing and crouch light punch. Nothing big deal. Crouching half punch startup has been set earlier. Overall recovery has been reduced. Great.
Ooh.
Headbutt. Yeah.
Oh.
Headbutt. Opponents can now be stunned. Shh, that's actually kind of awesome. Because that's kind of important to tell about. The headbutt used to cancel the stun. Because they would create a hard knockdown. But if the guy is about to stun and you headbutt him, he will get stunned now.
Oh, wow. That sucks. Okay, now I understand.
Yeah. Tiger Neck Chancery, the overall recovery has been increased. That's not a problem.
Okay, just when you make it fair. Yeah.
Birds of Paradise, it's his climax. Opponents can now be stunned after a hit. Same thing, nothing changed. All his moves that used to cause hard heavy knockdowns now can cause stun if the guy is on stun mode.
Mm-hmm.
Buffs everywhere, and hell.
Oh boy.
Hard light kick. The hitbox has been increased for the glory of the people. Far heavy kick, hitbox has been increased. By the way, when they say the hitbox on the far heavy kick has been increased, I urge you all to test it. It's ridiculous. It hits everything. The end chain blow, the recovery time has been reduced, doesn't hit back after hit or guard. The blow is the one where she is the unblockable.
Ah.
The neck cutter, when she jumps on the guy's neck,
yeah,
can now be confirmed on crouching opponents. So,
ooh.
Great. Yeah. A circle high, hit stun has been reduced. That's because that move could be actually very, very abused. And circle feint can now be super canceled. So you can cancel the unchain into a super if you do the feint before. It's just for some mix-up. Actually, good stuff with her. It's still a hard character to use, but if you want to learn her, now you have a lot, you have more options with both of her kicks.
Yep.
Also on buff view, population Team Mexico. King of Dinosaurs. Yeah. The Ankylo Hammer, heavy version. The limitation of the OTG part pattern so the opponent knocked to the ground. It's the move where he scratched the ground.
Yeah, the
The heavy version now used to hit on the first one, now hits on the second and the third one. Just that. Giga Campi, damage value has been reduced. Is the OTG. Dinner of Dinosaur, hitbox has been increased. I don't know what is the Dinner of Dinosaur. The name is great, by the way. Dinner of Dinosaur. Ah, it's his special.
Oh, is that what? Okay, I was trying to figure out what's the name.
It's the one where he runs.
Gotcha, gotcha.
So, hitbox has been increased, and the max version, the hitbox has been increased, and the active time has been increased. So, pretty much buffs all around, and a fix on the OTG pattern. No big deal. By the way, also, weird buffs. Shunei dash startup frames have been reduced. Spectre extension, but only the max versions of both his moves, the max version of his fists. So the damage value has been reduced on the red one, and the damage value has been increased on the blue one. Only that. I don't know why the change, but I believe just because people didn't use the blue one, so now it does more damage, but it travels less. So maybe it's a fair trade. Now the long list of trying to make the character work. Tung Fu Rui. So sad for Tung. Far Half Punch, hitbox has been increased. Thank God. Crouching Half Punch, hitbox has been increased. The opponent behaviors when hitting a crouching opponent has been fixed. Now he hits crouching opponents.
Huh.
We have a follower on Reddit that streams from time to time. I will try to get his name. And he actually plays with Tung as a like love character, you know, something that he actually likes. If I don't get it in 10 seconds, I'll try again.
Wait, is it Gil Stole My Ride?
Yes, thank you, Gil okay. Stole My Ride. Yes, he actually plays with Tung from like, he loves the character, so he plays with Tung. So that's something that I saw him streaming once, and he complained a lot because of the crouching half punch didn't hit in crouching opponents. Since he's such a short guy, it's like makes no reason, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Jump half punch, hitbox increased, active time increased. So, all good. Oh God. I will have to talk in Japanese now. Wait a second.
What? Hasn't Gyaku? Wait. One back before that.
Yeah.
Okoryu? Okoryu. I think it's Koryu. Because it's like the way you're pronouncing it.
Okoryu.
Because it sounds familiar.
You have to do the Japanese voice.
Yeah.
Okoryu.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, Okoryu. Because it sounds familiar. I've seen that move somewhere else, but I forgot where.
It's the command normal.
Mm-hmm.
So the command normal, hitbox has been increased, hitback distance during guard has been reduced. Well, that's pretty good, actually. Ooh. The Hensen Kyaku, throw range has been increased. So, okay. Hensen Kyaku is the... The throw, the DP throw.
Mm.
People usually don't use it. Now you have a reason to. Senpuken, the air one, recovery time after landing from jump has been extended. So, again, buff. Sensipo, overall recovery reduced. Shuha, overall hitbox has been increased. Shuha EX, hitbox has been increased. Shuha is the pump-up.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know exactly what you're expecting. Daigekiho, time allowed to follow up with another attack has been reduced. Advanced and Climax cancel input timings have been adjusted. That was a problem, more of a bug than anything else, But since his special Dai Gekiho is the, I believe it's the large projectile. It was very hard to cancel, so they fixed that. And the simple Gouken is the launch. Also has a higher hitbox in the normal version and more damage on the max version. So pretty much only buffs. Mm-hmm. Meirei-kun, another character that actually didn't need anything, got better.
Oh yeah, he did.
Far heavy kick hitbox has been increased, and the far heavy kick is, even with the increase, is still a very short move. So only slightly more useful now. The nerf, it's not really a nerf. So the Nezo Hangeki, it's the
formerly overhead.
That's mm-hmm. right. Now, so the Nezo Hangeki is
the command normal.
Damage, stun, and guard crush's value have been reduced, but changes to the opponent's behaviors on hit. So they just changed the way it works.
So basically, a good way to put it is that you lose Oki because no longer a hard knockdown overhead, but now you can combo into Neomax.
No, now you can combo it to a lot of things.
A lot of things, actually, what I should say.
You can actually do the normal, command normal into pillow now. Mm-hmm. Before you couldn't.
Yep.
And the Gekiho, the amount of power gauge has been reduced. So most people don't know, because Meiten-kun is a new character and he's kind of weird. But the more you charge with him, the more damage he does.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like forever, but he has three stages of charge. And somehow they thought it would be a good idea that if you charge longer, you will create more meter.
Not exactly. Wow. Yeah.
So they changed that. And Gekiho is the same move from Tung, is the vertical
punch thing that he does.
In the eye, it's the key, you know.
Oh, okay, yeah, that one, yeah.
So Zarina, another character that got just enough nerf to people not call her broken.
Yeah, I know.
So Pedencon pruning, I'm pretty sure that's someone trying to speak Portuguese. Only hits opponent in the air and during hit stun. Okay, it's the... what move is that? I believe it's the command normal, but let me be certain.
No, well, it says EX, so it's definitely not it's a special.
Oh, no, it's not.
I'm trying to remember if...
It's the DP, the one where she kicks... she lays on the ground and the raises, you know, like...
Okay, there we go.
Yeah, only hits opponent in the air and during hits stun. So, sure. It's probably something... And the last one, the growing... the growing flower is the Eddie Gordo kicks.
Gotcha, yeah, Eddie Gordo kicks.
Yeah, they fixed the collision because used to have a bug.
Is that that's the other whole, the flying thing?
Yeah. Yes, that's the... so she can funny. No longer make people fly.
Yeah. Oh, jeez.
So, unless the pendulum pruning, it's something that there was a bug. Her changes were bug fixes mostly.
Yeah.
Bandeiras Hattori. Sankaku Tobi,
wall jump,
adjusted. Mm-hmm. Crouching Light Punch, charges into the cancel input window. All right, so you can crouch a light punch up to grab the guy. Mm-hmm. Good change.
Yeah.
Jumping light touch hitbox has been increased. Jump light kick hitbox has been increased. Jumping half touch startup has been set earlier. Jumping half kicks hitbox has been increased. And Kabuto Wari.
Yeah, you got it right.
Yeah, no, I'm trying to see what movie is. What's the movie?
Also, like, it says cancel version. So,
Yeah.
Could that be a teleport? No, why would it say cancel version?
Kabuto Wari is the command normal.
Oh, the command normal. Okay. Yeah, there. Okay, that makes sense. Yeah, cancel version. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, it's the slash, the hand slash.
Mm-hmm.
The hitbox has been increased. That's actually kind of good. I tried to play Bandeiras a lot. And he used that. It was very easy to miss the command normal because of the short range. So that should be good for us.
Mm-hmm.
And one more on population buff, Nelson. Farlight kick, hitbox size has been increased upward. Far heavy kick, hitbox has been increased downward. Mm-hmm. So the jumps, it's kind of weird because his far heavy kick is actually a punch, so we have to try it. Crouching light kick can now be canceled into special moves.
Okay.
And it can be canceled into his chain. So that's the main change. I found an opening. Damage value has been increased. That's the back jump, back punch.
Okay.
Reap. Damage and guard crush values have been increased. What? Okay. Reap is the heavy deep punch.
Yeah. Keep going. There's more. With the same
Laid
thing.
Lay down. Damage and guard crush has been increased. The jumping Vanessa punch. It's over. Damage, stun, and guard crush value has been increased. The it's over is the one where he does the 1-2 that Vanessa also did.
Yeah.
Range open. The startup has been set earlier. The overall recovery has been reduced. I don't know what range open is. Let me see. I believe it's the one with the mechanical arm. Let me see.
Oh no! Help! Pox will be pissed if he found out we didn't know about his boy.
Oh yeah. No. Sorry. it's the back half punch is the yes, it's the hook, the mechanical arm hook.
Okay.
A step into victory, heavy version. The striking invincibility has been increased. Command moves can now be canceled earlier, and that's a big change because a step into victory is his dash.
Ah, the dash, yeah.
You can now do light dash into heavy dash, like you can do it instantly. It's pretty good now. Uh-huh. And a step into Victor EX version, invincibility has been increased, means invincibility all the way. Okay, just so we are clear. Yes, that's it. It's invincible now. It's a dash properly.
Mm-hmm.
Sylvie. Far light punch, hitbox has been increased. Far heavy punch, hitbox has been increased. Stretch on.
What a name.
Yes, it's the command normal. That's a cool command normal because now it's a launch.
It's the
one where she stretches, literally she stretches her arms. If you are not in a combo, you will now launch the guy. Discharging. Wow, I never noticed her move's name. Yep, every day is a school day. So discharging is the quarterback punch. It's the That's the best I could do.
I know, I got just fine.
Yeah. Paul experiment. Recovery time when landing from jump has been increased. It's the special where she probably runs around. No, that's the Magneto track. Oh, no, that's it. The Paul experiment is when the spinning special.
Ah, okay.
So now recovery time when landing from a jump has been increased. It's not exactly from a jump. It's just that when she lands, you have a have more recovery now.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And Magneto Trap, a special follow attack box has been added. So this is a mistake from the patch notes. Luckily, Gunsmith told me that, and then he showed me. What I actually mean is the Magneto Trap, now it's all juggler. You can hit on air.
Ah, okay. It's, yeah.
Okay, that's what it means. Kukri, Far Heavy Kick. Quick Max Mode can no longer be activated after hit confirmation or during guard. Have no idea what it is.
It was like a weird bug, I guess, that he did. That, I guess, made it. I guess it was just weird. It was just too weird to explain, so it was just better for them to fix it. I saw examples on it, and it's like I still couldn't understand what they meant. But okay, I guess it meant to be fixed. Yeah.
So and now my move has been buffed. Fusaken. The hitbox has been increased. If the command normal now hits crouching opponents.
Gotcha.
Okay. Just in case people don't know, you can call me any way you want. The proper pronunciation is Fuso. That's exactly what you are reading on the Kukri move list. It means snitch, by the way, in Italian. Yes, that's what it means. Gotcha. Jhené Sajin, the amount of power meter attributed when activated has been increased. The projectile resistance value has been adjusted. So his fireball had some weird properties, like it would sometimes cancel other hitboxes, cancel what fireballs, or sometimes it would not. It could not be reflected by Kula, but could be reflected by Athena. So they made it so it works more or less like a proper
projectile. Ring, I guess is a good way.
Projectile, yes. And then the other moves here are the when you do the down with EX version, no, the down, the teleport. Mm-hmm. Now you can nullify the projectiles with your Phantom Sand Ghost. So you create a wall between the projectile and you. So pretty much buffs all around for Kukri. A great character. A lot of people love the design. I love and I'm bad with him, but I'm getting a little better. It will be fun to play. Mian has been nerfed. BNQ, the invincibility has been removed if you are on the air. So she works more like Seth now.
Yeah.
People who used to, yeah. By the way, nobody talked about it, but Seth would be a great character on the roster for DLC.
Oh, I know, right? Oh, I missed him.
Yes. He's so unique. He would be great in here. And then, you know what? Completely off topic, you Seth, Vanessa, because they are partners. Mm-hmm. And you know who could be the third guy?
Who?
Kevin Ryan.
Stop right there.
And they are going after Xanadu for
oh man,
for breaking out of prison.
Holy moly, the cop team.
Yep. The big team
should be the name. NWA? Yep. Fuck the police? Not those three. Nuh-uh.
Yep. No. Not here, I speak.
Oh, no.
So, yeah. So, Oda, I know you don't speak that much English, but if someone can tell you in your sweet ear, I gave you the DLC, okay? DLC thing packet for you.
Oh,
just make it and I will throw you money.
There you go.
So let's talk about Mion now. So we have BNQ now not having invincibility on air. It's okay. Not a lot of people is able to hit on air. The BNQ follow-ups all have the read box size shortened.
Mm-hmm.
But the amount of power and the amount of meter they also has been reduced. So, you know, you didn't spend BNQ just to get meter.
Third strike meter meta gone.
Yes. It was her thing.
Once again, thank you to Renault for being the smartass when he did that strategy himself.
Yes, now everybody has to play her right.
Yep.
The hidden Nenbu is her special, the kick one.
Okay, yeah.
Where she goes flying around, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So is invincible now in the startup. So it's good for the family now. Before it could you could cancel it with a jab, you know? So not that many players would do that special role, but if you're playing online and the connection is bad,
there that's you go. Use that lag.
Sometimes you have to do things that you are not proud of. Hey, it works. So now we are going to the bosses. Also known as the one guy SNK really don't want to make good, and the one guy SNK actually wants to make good. So, Antonov, or Mr. Satan.
Yeah,
Mr. Satan. Oh, close half punch. Startup time has been set earlier, so above. Yay! Vertical Macho. Great name.
Yeah, I know, right?
Great name. Changes to the opponent behavior at the fourth hit. I don't know what that is, or maybe I do. No, I got it. The vertical macho is the move where he does the multiple hits. Now it's a launcher. Good thing.
Okay.
Bad thing. Gigantic back, you know, when he throws his back at you.
Yeah, you know, flexing and everything.
Yeah. Now you can't combo with itself, you know, you can go gigantic back into gigantic back. So that's maybe a nerf or something that wasn't supposed to happen, but at the same time it did happen on the Antonov trailer. So I don't know, maybe they thought it was too much. I didn't. But now you can jump in, you can launch and do the gigantic back for pretty much the same damage. So overall, he's still not that good.
No, he's not that good. I mean, if you play him, now you can play that one song from Ice Cube. You can do it. Put your back into it when you do that special move.
Yes, you can.
All right, yep. Verse.
No. That's I will let that sink in. So, Verse. Our Netherrealm boss.
Yeah, never.
Yeah. Farlight punch. Hitbox has been shortened. Nobody's complaining about that. Far half quick. Guard point active time has been shortened. Now that's sad.
Yeah.
That's sad. That was such a great use of guard point. Well, bro.
Now you got to do it right.
He's still being used. Yeah. He's still being used. So, okay. Crouching heavy punch. Damage and stun values has been increased.
Reduced.
Ooh, reduced. Sorry. I've read. Yeah. So crouching heavy punch. It's the fist down? No, it's not. So, okay. Just a minor fix. Giga power bomb. The throw tech issue, which was occurring at special times after the grab confirmation, has been fixed. So it's working like you know, but now some bugs that used to happen with the, you know, like being a ranged throw. Now you have to... Oh no, Giga Power Bomb is the proper throw. So yeah.
Yeah, it's just a normal throw that, you know, you'll be like, oh hey, let me just throw tech at the last second. Yeah.
Yes, and you could. Yeah. So now you can't. So the move that I was thinking about is actually the
The next one.
Stray head. Hitbox has been shortened. In that case, is the fireball.
Mm.
So the fireball has been shortened. So it's okay. No big deal. The darkness collision. Hurtbox has been increased.
Ooh.
Darkness collision. I believe it's the one where he punched the floor.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
So it's a better move now, but only the light version. Stray scaffold. Recovery time has been increased. Stray scaffold is the, I believe it's the scissors, the air scissors.
Okay.
Okay, the bison move, the general move. Both normal and EX version, recovery time. And the Groot Dimension. Throw invincibility has been increased. So Groot Dimension is his climax.
Ah, okay, the climax.
So he has he's invincible. He's throwing in the climax. Yeah. So that's worse. He got some nerfs, but I still think that if you liked him before, you still like him.
I still like him.
His ranged throw didn't have any change. That was what most people were afraid of.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a cool mechanic. It's powered, so it will stay. Mm-hmm. So that's what changed the most about the character. And he's the last one. I mean,
no, that was
we
the last
still
one.
Have a. He was the last one, but from in the 4 or 5 days since our last transmission, we had another patch.
Oh yeah, that's right. I was about to tell you about that too.
Yeah.
I guess we go over with. Yeah, I guess might as well bring it
up.
Yeah,
let's do it. Yeah. So it's mostly a bug patch.
Just a bug. Yeah.
Last week, like, yeah, bug patches will still be happening from time to time. Balance patches, probably not. So the issue appearing in story mode after beating Antonov with specific team has been fixed. So from what I could gather, if you were playing with the official invitation team, or the is the official invitation or the another world team, the cutscene was switched, but not switched. Like they were all playing the cookery cutscene, you know.
Oh, weird.
So that okay. Yeah, but that's something that only happened in the patch. So text issues during the tutorial have been fixed. It's a typo. It was a typo. Not big deal. I never saw, but looks like there was the and the on the next line, you know, like two the's on a row.
Ah. Okay.
Also never noticed because my game is important.
Yeah.
And other minor bugs have been fixed. So yeah, other minor bugs have been fixed. Good luck knowing what they are.
Yeah.
Looks like they fixed the throw, the Antonov throw.
Mm-hmm.
That's what some people told me, but I haven't tried it yet. Now, some things that happen that people say that kind of screw things up, but from my experience, it was the other way around. They had some changes from the search mode and things like that. So the acquisition of room information has been improved, and it actually has. So now you know exactly the. You don't know you. It's not only the guy who created the room that you can see the connection speed. You know people who's inside, and they will give you a normalizer. You know something. So if one guy has 4, the other guy has 1, it will be a 2 bars connection. That's it. The letters position of enter displaying while waiting in training mode in ranked match has been adjusted. So that, let me be pretty clear here. You couldn't see before, now you can.
Ah, okay.
Okay, it was white on white, so you couldn't see it before. And the online functionalities have been improved. From I saw on I believe it was Dream Campso. They tested it, and it looks like that if someone outside of your country has a better connection than someone inside your, not exactly country, inside your region, you can play with him. Some people say that it may create some lag just because of distance traveling time, but from what I started playing against a lot of Chileans and Argentinians, and I didn't have that issue. So maybe it's not that big of a deal. It's probably something more visible on Europe or the US, where you now you have to play with Mexicans and other Central Americans.
Yeah, or maybe Central Americans, yeah.
Yeah, so maybe there it is a problem. But in South America, at least on the south cone of the continent, we don't have that problem. It's close enough so we can play just fine. So maybe it was great on China and Japan and South America, maybe not that great on the US and Central America. And in Europe, a lot of people saying that they are getting good connection with like France to UK, France to Spain, France to Italy. But if they grab someone from Sweden or Russia, it's not that good. So, but that's something they had to do in those regions where the game is not that popular, you know? Mm-hmm. So yeah, sure. Here in Latin America, you will pretty much only fight people on your own region, but that's not what players from other places were having the same experience, you know? I believe that we have someone from Italy, I believe, on the subreddit, and he says that before the patch, he never found anyone, and now he finds some other Europeans. The connection is not that great, but it's better than not playing.
Yeah.
So maybe that was a decision SNK made. They should only fix that. Not only the first guy who appears is the guy you fights, but that they maybe do a priority list, you know?
Yeah.
Like someone appears, wait for like 5 seconds, see if someone on the same region appears, and then put that guy on hold. Maybe something like that. But that's the changes. Also, some bug fixes from characters. Nothing big deal here. Robert Garcia, far heavy kick. The deviating hitbox issue when performing this move while pressing back or forward or else has been fixed. So that was something that a lot of people caught very early. But the far half kick had been nerfed. It didn't have that much of a hitbox. But if you hit down just before hitting, like you half kick just down on the sequence, the previous hitbox was active, you know? Something, just a problem with the coding of the game. The Gene Kyaku, the missing hurt box when hitting the opponent has been fixed. So they try to create a hurt box on the kicks. But there's something. There was some problems, and now they fix. They fix in like 3 days. We cannot complain that much.
Yeah.
King Hangetsu-san, the wrong position of queen the opponent blocks on specific timing has been fixed. Since he's a down charge, and you could down charge became a forward charge, it should work still for a down up. It wasn't, so they fixed that. Athena, the same thing from Robert. If you any input beyond the heavy kick made the move hit further. Xanadu finding. To cancel the version of finding that didn't come out after canceling a farlight kick or a crouching heavy kick has been fixed. So finding is his trick, is his unlike other characters where you have to press down and have kick, in his case is down heavy punch. But it's something that you usually do on block strings. You go like down, light kick, have kick, so you can do some sort of pressure. It wasn't working with Xanadu. He would create an ethereal move. It wouldn't hit. That was fixed. Okay, jump blowback. It's no longer possible to perform an R minute spike by whiffing this move. So that's a big change. A lot of people noticed that the old properties of the minute spike would be applied if you were on a jump blowback or on a backdash. So like you just after the end trigger hit, you could press backdash and then do the minute spike
in the area.
Really quick, it would still work like it used to, so they fixed that. And the hit drive max version, it's no longer possible to perform another hit drive after loading a first one at specific timings. It's a glitch, no big deal. Neck, the command input window has been softened. You get out of the bird. Some people expressed that it was hard to get out of the bird, and it really was. So now it should be easier. Mui Mui, the no tame Kodaki, the one frame input for cancelling from close half punch at fix is her command grab, you know, the Karin command grab. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So now it's a one frame input.
Okay.
It's supposed to be like that, but if you were on the combo, it wouldn't. It's the opposite of what you expect. And the finish in the Angel, finish neck cutter, it's no longer possible to perform this during the throw invincibility. It was just if someone would grab Angel while she was on the after a block string before the neck cutter, you could still do the neck cutter and it would look glitched as all fuck, and now it's fixed. Yeah.
Gotcha.
Tumfuru, the far heavy punch has been fixed, but unlike Athena and Robert, if you press anything other than the far heavy punch, you would have a shorter range. So, okay. The crouching heavy punch issue causing a standing opponent to be damaged as a crouching has been fixed. That's for the guard on the being fixed. And the Antonov throw has been fixed as well. And that's it.
Ooh-wee.
That's a lot of changes for a week.
Yeah. Oh, man. I was going to say, man, I kind of want to get this over with because, boy, I knew it was going to be a long podcast. We got to do it in two parts because, boy, this is another 90-minute pretty much plus, which is fine. Like I said, I knew that it was going to be this long. I just wanted to make sure it's not too long, you know. So
it was 22 pages of changes, right?
Yeah, it was. So, yeah, we had to make it this long and make sure that people understand what's going on. So it's
and
fine.
Also, a lot of those things we were talking about were just where Greek for someone who is not aware of the move names or what are the, and we had to explain something. It's just common courtesy, you know. But just before we go, you have anything to say about Canada Cup?
Well, we will discuss about that for the next one.
Sure.
Because honestly, we just don't have enough more time, but we will have a. We'll have like a special one where we'll discuss about Canada Cup and then the future of the Reddit.
Sure.
Because I am going to bring some interesting stuff to the subreddit in the future. So we'll save this for the next one where we'll give ourselves time to plan it out. We will discuss Canada Cup for the next one. I just wanted to make this a patch only, you know, podcast. But for those that are listening and are watching the penny, don't you worry. Canada Cup will be on the next one. And whatever tournament also happens to be coming by. I don't think there is one yet. So we can safely discuss Canada Cup for the next one.
But yeah. Just one thing before we go. To all those haters that say that Bird Josh would be fucked without neck. Dude is better than we gave him credit for. That's all I'm saying.
Not if he stops spamming freaking with Mature. Yeah, he can play solid if he stops spamming that DP with Mature. So I'm not, until I see him improve, I'm not going to give him that much credit. I hope he hears this. No. Oh, yeah. If he stops spamming, I'll give him credit. But for now, he ain't no.
Yeah, can you see Xiaohai spamming? No. Of course he won't. Oh. Fisio, Panda, nope. So be more active. You are doing fine. Just don't play like me.
Yeah, okay. Just don't give up. Like, he was, I know this. Like, he plays in other tournaments where he's doing solid, and then suddenly when Mature comes in, well, I better do EX thing over and over again.
If something doesn't work, repeat it until it does.
Until it does, or you already lost. You lost a round. And exactly. The commentator themselves had to tell you, yo, Nerdjosh, stop.
Stop, Nerdjosh. Stop. We can no longer call him Bird Josh.
Yeah, that's right. No, now he's back to Nerdjosh.
Yeah, spam Josh.
Yeah, spam. Yeah. Josh. God. I will call him that if he doesn't stop.
Yes.
Come on, Nerdjosh. I know you play solid. Just stop with that nonsense with Mature. Man.
Come on. This game needs the American hero.
I know. Jeez. If anything, or I don't know, man. If Nerdjosh can be our hero, Hell Pockets, come back to us, man.
Oh, yeah.
Come back to your glory years, your top level years in 13. Anyways, before I keep rambling. thank you again, Fosso, because I definitely need your help on this one. And for those that are watching, whether you download the audio or you're watching on YouTube, thank you again. Thank you for your patience. I try to get this as fast as possible, but, you know, again, IRL happens. I can't just force Fosso with a crack of whip to, you know, just give me stuff right away. No, that's not how that works.
No, my boss does that for you. Don't worry.
Yeah. Oh, boy. But thank you again. And for those that are watching, as always, good games, peace out, and stop by the Reddit if you haven't done so.
Oh, yeah. And we are nice, I swear.
Yeah, we're not. Trust me, we are.